Oh.
Musicians, everybody, we thank the Lord for what he's doing and what he's going to do. Want to say good morning to baby? And I promise you one thing, you need to hear me now. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy will come in the morning. I want you to look up and look to the hills from which cometh your help. Love you very much, baby. Have a good day and keep trusting in the Lord. Amen. It's time for the word of God again. Dre, y'all ready? You ready, Derek? All right. I think y'all ready. We got another special guest with us today. I won't call him a special guest. He's a brother. Long time brother. We grew up together as boys. And God let us come back together. We wanted to sing so bad until we both played guitar. Yeah, I used to play guitar. Yeah.
All right.
And we would go up and we would sing. We were saying this real famous song, Stand By Me, My Love. And I'm a living witness today. The Lord will stand by us. Brother Burns gonna come in a little bit and sing for us. There's a word from the Lord. Oh, let me say, God bless you to Reverend Williams. He's one of the ministers that always checking on us and seeing how we're doing, but God just don't visit certain families. He visited our family. We had death in the family. Amen. I send the program out to all of our members, all of our sick members. One of our mothers we had prayer with on last week. This program go out to you and keep the faith. God has the last say. It ain't over until God says it's over. And when he says it's over, you don't even have to be sick. Your time will just be up. And he'll come take us away. But there's a word from the Lord in Luke chapter number 23. One of the Gospels, Luke chapter number 23. And I believe we want to look at verse number 33. And it says, and when they were come to the place, put a pin in there, to the place, which is called Calvary, there they crucified him. That was a death sentence. Crucified him and the malefactors. One Bible might read thieves. The malefactors, one on the right hand of him and the other on the left. I'm going to talk about today Christ, the man in the middle. Jesus Christ, God's son, was the man in the middle. Don't leave home without it.
Amen.
Don't do anything without him, because we will need him We never know when a storm is going to rise. And if you don't leave him, when that storm, just like this virus, gets so bad, amen, you'll think about like they did in Mark 4 and say, he's on board with us. Go down into the hem, the bottom of the ship, they did, and they shook him. And the scripture read, and said unto him, Master. I don't think that's the way they said it like that. I think they shook him and said, Master. You see, they was afraid. Right. Carest thou not that we perish? He could have said, I got this. He could have said, let me wake up now and see what I can do. But Jesus, being who he was, he hushed the sleep out of his eyes and he gets up. How many of you believe today he'll get up? Can I get a witness out there? Somebody listening to me. You just need him to get up. You have become so dismayed and so downhearted. You have allowed the life of Jesus in you to go to sleep. They went down there and they shook him and said, Master, carest thou not that we perish? He gets up and he looked at the storm, the raging winds and the waves, the water rise, and the disciples were there and they feared their life. And Jesus said, and I don't imagine he had to say this loud. I imagine he just said, peace be still.
Yes, Lord.
You see what I'm saying? Peace be still. And the wind ceased. And that bad storm obeyed his voice. And it was so miraculous unto the disciples, looked one to the other and said, y'all see this? What manner? What manner of man is this? That even the sea, the wind and the waves obey his voice. And they talked to Jesus for a while, and Jesus said unto them, you should have known this. I'm talking to the Christian people now. I'm talking to the ones that study Christians that have been going to church every Sunday. Sunday school, on different boards in the church. He told us way back yonder a storm was going to come up. We just didn't know when, and it just so happened to be the coronavirus, COVID-19, but didn't I tell you?
Yes.
When the storms of life arrayed that I would stand by.
Yes.
He looked at them and oh, said, oh, thou, such a little faith. Your faith is messed up. What is faith? Hebrews 11:1 says, now faith. Right now, apply to whatever you do. Right now. Now faith is the what? Substance of things hoped for is the evidence of things not seen. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Hey, you don't always see the things that God don't do for you, but I imagine you can be a witness today and so whatever you have asked the Lord to do, he'll do. Christ the man in the mirror. Woo, God Almighty. Amen, amen. The Roman soldiers, they didn't know what they were doing, but they were the one that carried out this crucifixion. Oh, but if they knew that they were crucifying the Lord, maybe they would have had a different perspective. But Jesus being who he is, and he looked at the situation and said to himself, they don't know. He said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Amen. Departed his raiment and cast lots. He'll do us like that. When we do wrong, he'll look at our situation and say, forgive them, forgive lots, because he don't know what he's doing. No matter what we do, it is nothing to us to let us know that he cares. Can I get a witness today? No matter what it is, no matter what, they couldn't have known they was crucifying the Lord. Oh, I feel good today. Not the man on the right prayer. Not the man on the left, but the man that was in the middle. You hear what I'm saying? And Jesus was a man in the middle, but they had to get him to the place. And you see, people sometimes they want to get in the right place, get in the right spot, get in front of the right people, and then somebody you thought you knew will call themselves telling your head a mess.
Yes, sir.
Or saying what they want to say. They got him to the place. And this place, which is called Calvary. Everybody say Calvary. Calvary. Got him to Calvary. Amen. Calvary was an unusual place. Calvary was not like Mount Olive of a sweet spell way of memory. Where he used the clouds and his chariot and the wind, where the steed, where he went back home to God, sat down at the right hand of him in the kingdom. Calvary. Calvary was not like Mount Sinai, where he gave the law to Moses, not to be hoped to whisper of the great century, but where the proclamation broke the age-long silence of the desert. Calvary. I might hear it here from him that would be great. My. That's good right there. We don't have it. Calvary was not like Olive, where Jesus went in. Not even like Gethsemane. It was that garden that Jesus went in to pray, and he prayed. Oh my God, did he pray? Lord, he prayed until his sweat. Amen. That fell from his face with the drops of blood. And the wine that was with him, that God was going to get your friends and let you down when you get in trouble. Amen. They had fallen asleep. But he said, Father, woo! Lord, if it's possible, if you're willing, please, Lord, let this cup pass from me. Somebody going through something right now and you listen to me. Just pray and ask him to let it pass. And mommy, you can say when the storm cloud pass over, it would be all right. But somehow my thing had got him. Not the man on the right, not the man on the left, but the man in the middle. God gave him power. He could walk by and got him. And he was able to face his enemy. He said to him in a sense, I'm not gonna run. If you think I'm gonna run away from you, nail my feet. And I'm not gonna find you. You can nail my hand. And if they had a cross, yeah, Lord. And then they had a crown of thorns, waiting to push down on his head. And then when they pushed the thorns down on his head, let it begin to ooze in and out of his flesh. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord, they carried him from judgment hall to judgment hall. Yes, they did. They brought him before Pilate. Pilate tried him. He tried him. Oh, Lord, one of the kind. let me burn. My brother's gonna come see for us now. Remember, Jesus Christ is, was the man in the middle.
Amen. Happy now, I tell you.
Crucified. No, being a part of our service. If you would like to visit our website, also you can go to our website, littlebrittonshipmbc.com. Or you can send gifts to our Values app to LFMBC. We want you to show us we're doing good and we're not begging anybody, but show us that you appreciate it. But remember, on that cross, Jesus died for you and for me. Great. Before we give a benediction here, we're going to say it again. The doors of the church are still open. Laverne didn't tell me this, but y'all hit one of these mornings. Come back, girl. And as he comes, just remember, we thank God for you. My God, girl, you got me sitting today, man. I'm going to stand up here with you, girl.
Come on, God. Man, this wasn't rehearsed. It was just the Holy Ghost doing this.